One senior financial figure last year called for, quote, more consistent regulation. Well, that person was Esther Levanon, the chief executive of the Tel Aviv Stock Exchange, and she joins me now. Good morning to you.
Good morning, Andrea.
Tell me, first of all, what do you make of Obama's plans? Do you think that they're implementable, and do you think there can be consistency across the world?
Well, first of all, better late than never. I think that I don't know about consistency all over the world, but if I speak for Israel, we've been there long ago. And we used last year even to make tougher regulation than used to be before with the banks. But that's part of the reason why Israel found itself almost out of the crisis in terms of the banking community. None of the banks in Israel were affected because almost none of them were involved in the toxic acid instrument before that.
And was that to do with tighter regulation? I mean, did the regulation prevent them being involved with toxic assets?
I think that's part of, most of it was because of the regulation. Israel was named number 7 in the world in regulation by the World Bank in 2008, so that's probably means something.
Well, no, last year, the benchmark index in Israel jumped 75%. Stocks recovered so quickly. Was the banking regulation a part of your quick recovery?
No, I think that we should attribute to a lot of factors. First of all, the economy. The economy was in very good situation when we started the crisis. We had only 2 quarters of a crisis, and then the economy picked up again. We had no problems with the banks. We didn't have a real estate bubble. So as a whole, the economy was very sound, and that's why you pick up so quickly.
Now, there is a trend where Israeli companies, like high-tech companies, are inclined to list outside Israel on, say, the NASDAQ. Is that something that you would like to change?
Well, we don't mind them being listed on NASDAQ as well as they're also listed in Tel Aviv. There are about 55 companies dual listed, most of them with NASDAQ and Tel Aviv. It's not the same trading hours, so it doesn't affect us. It only contributes to the companies. So it's good for everyone.
And what about those that are not listed in Tel Aviv and simply listed on the NASDAQ?
Well, we are trying to let them see the light and come to Tel Aviv, but there are only few of them. And now we are trying to convince new high-tech companies to list first in Tel Aviv and then see whether the big world is good for them or not.
Now, high-tech companies are obviously doing very well in Israel, but what are the other key areas that investors should be looking at in Israel?
Well, we have very big pharmaceutical companies like Teva. We have chemical companies like Israel Chemicals. We even found gas lately in Israel, which is something no one ever believed we'll find. There's a very good industry. So there's a lot of areas to invest in Israel, not only high tech.
Now, just before we go, Israel is due to be raised from emerging market status, and that's going to take effect in May.
Yes.
What effect is that going to have?
Well, we'll probably see a different mixture of investors in Israel. Those who follow MSCI indices of emerging market probably will pull out, but on the other hand, we are going to see a lot of investors that are interested in developed market that were never allowed to invest in Israel before. So that's why I'm here, to try to convince them to see what Israel can offer them.
Good luck with that, Esther Levanon. Thanks very much indeed
for
joining us.